Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to learn the multiplication instructions in the ARM7 programming. We have already studied few instructions related to the arithmetic logical operations. So now in this section, we are going to study multiplication instruction. Now multiplication instructions are used to perform multiplication operation. So ARM basically provide two multiplication instructions. Now these two are the basic multiplication instructions which ARM provide. First one is MUL, that is multiply. So this instruction is used to multiply two numbers, and second one is multiply and accumulate. So in this instruction, basically first multiplication operation is performed and then one number is added to that particular product of the two numbers. Okay, so multiplication plus addition operation is performed in this MLA instruction. Now MLA stand for multiply accumulate. Now extension of these two instructions are nothing but unsigned and signed number with long. Okay, so this is unsigned multiplication instruction which is long. So unsigned long multiply, then we are having unsigned long multiply with accumulate, that is UMLA long. U stand for unsigned, MLA stand for multiply and accumulate, and L stand for long. Then we are having SMULL, that is sign multiply long, and then we are having sign multiply and accumulate long, or sign long multiply with accumulate. Okay, so we are going to study these six instructions in this session. So as I said, MUL stand for multiply. So this is the simplest multiplication instruction which perform multiplication of two numbers. It multiplies two 32 bit numbers held in registers. So basically it performed multiplication operation on two numbers which are stored in the register and store the 32 bit result in destination register. Please note this point. It store only 32 bit result, not 64 bit result, because most of the time if we multiply two 32 bit numbers, then 64 bit result may be generated. So it store only only 32 bit results. Okay, multiplying two 32 bit numbers together gives rise to 64 bit number. The MUL instruction only stores the lower 32 bits of the product. So after multiplication, if we get 64 bit, normally we get 64 bit number. So lower 32 bit numbers are stored in the MUL instruction. Please note this point. Now the ARM also has four instructions for multiplying 32 bit numbers together and retaining all 64 bits of the product. So these are unsigned multiply long, unsigned multiply and accumulate long, sign multiply long, and sign long multiply and accumulate. So please note this point. In MUL instruction, upper 32 bits are not stored, only lower 32 bits are stored. But whereas in long instructions or long multiply, all these 64 bits we can retain. So next important thing is instruction format. So before studying any instruction, you should understand the instruction format. It is very, very important. Okay. Now for multiply and accumulate instruction, we are going to study this format. So 32 bit by 32 bit multiplication is done and bottom 32 bit result is stored. Bottom means lower 32 bits. Okay. Now the format is like this. For MUL instruction, we are having MUL, then condition, we can put any conditional code in this section, then S if we want to update the flag bits which are stored in the CPSR register, then RD normally used to store result, RM and RS, here we can put two numbers inside these registers. So we can write this MUL instruction like this: MUL RD, which is used to store result, then RM and then RS. So this instruction will be executed like this: RM into R S. Okay. Now multiply and accumulate is little bit different. So here we're having MLA, then again condition S. So RD is used to store result, RM and RS. So multiplication of these two numbers are first done, and then RN is added into the multiplication. Okay, so this thing we'll see in the next slide. So here is the explanation related to this condition and optional conditional code S. So if S specified, the conditional code flags are updated, RD the result, then RM, RS and RN, these are the ARM registers holding the operands on which we have to perform operation. R15 cannot be used for any of the RD, RM or RS or RN section, because R15 is used for another purpose, like link register we have studied, okay, or stack pointer and all these things. Okay, now here use of these instructions, that is MUL and MLA. The MUL instruction multiplies the value from RM and RS. So these values are multiplied and places the least significant 32 bits into the RD. Okay, so this will be like this: RD is equal to RM and RS, which we studied in the previous slide. Then the MLA instruction multiplies the values from RM and RS. So this MLA instruction will be executed like this: result will be stored into the RD, and first multiplication of RM and RS is normally done, adds the values from RN, that is this, and places the least significant 32 bits result into the RD. So this MLA, multiply and accumulate instruction, is executed like this. So first multiplication of these two instruction is done, and then it will be added with this RN. Okay, so in this way this MUL and MLA instructions are executed. Now few examples of this MUL and MLA instructions. So we are having MUL, R0, R1, R2. So R1 and R2 are multiplied and product will be stored into the R0 register. So here is the explanation. MLA, so these two registers first multiplied here, and then R5 will be added into this and result will be stored into the R10 register. So here is the explanation. MUL S, so if we are appending S, then CPSR registers status or flag registers will be updated, that is NZCV. Okay, so these are the few examples related to this multiplication instruction. Now here we have completed this MUL and MLA instruction. Now we'll go into the unsigned and signed numbers. Okay, so again, whenever we try to understand the instruction, very first thing is instruction format. Okay, so as I said in the previous slides, MUL and MLA instruction store only 32 bit, lower 32 bit result. Now if we have to store 64 bit result, then in that case we have to use two registers. So for that purpose, the instruction format for these instructions will be different. So unsigned and signed long multiply and multiply accumulate, so 32 by 32 bit multiplication will be done, and 64 bit accumulator or result, accumulate or result will be stored. So the format is like this: first opcode, that is condition, then we are having S, that is to update the CPSR register. Condition may be UMULL or UMLLL, etc. Then here we are having two registers to store 64 bit result, RDL0. RDL0 store the lower 32 bit result. Okay, so L0 stand for lower, and RDHI, that is higher 32 bit result, is stored into this RDHI register. Okay, and multiplication of these two numbers will be performed, that is RM and RS. So here opcode is one of these four instructions inside this opcode section. Condition may be any conditional, then S, then RDL0HR, these are ARM registers for the result. So for UMLAL, that is unsigned multiply accumulate long, and sign, multiply, equivalent, they hold the accumulating value. Rm and Rs, they are normally used to hold the operand. R15 again cannot be used. So RDL0, RDHI and Rm must be the different registers. Okay, so these registers must be different. Okay, there are no specific registers like the name with the RDL0 or RDHI. These register must be different. That may be, it may be R0 and R1, etc. Okay. Now, so here we are having this use of this instruction. So the unsigned multiply long instruction interprets the values from RM and RS as unsigned integer. So this instruction multiply these two operands. Okay, so it will generate 64-bit result. It multiplies this integer and places the least significant 32-bit. Least significant 32-bit will be stored into the RDL0, and most significant 32-bit will be stored into the RDHI. Okay, now next instruction we will see, that is U, that is unsigned multiply and accumulate long. Okay, so in multiply and accumulate, we first perform multiplication and then we add one operand and then we store result inside the registers. So this instruction interprets the values from RM and RS as unsigned integer. It multiplies these integers and adds the 64-bit result to the 64-bit unsigned integer contained in the RDHI and RDLO. Okay, so this instruction basically accumulate this or add 64-bit result to the 64-bit unsigned integer contained in RDHI and RDLO. So basically this instruction add these two registers again and then it store result inside this register. So we'll see in the example section, we'll see this instruction in more detail. Then sign multiply long. So again, this instruction multiply these two numbers and complement sign integers. So complementing and all these things are related to the mathematical operation. So we'll not go into the detail why 2's complement is there, why multiplication is there. Okay, so for everything, there are certain mathematical concepts behind this. So this instruction basically perform multiplication of these two numbers. And then least significant bit will be stored, 32 bits will be stored into the RDL0 and most significant will be stored into the RDHI. Then sign, multiply and accumulate long. So this instruction multiplies RM and RS and then it multiplies these registers and add the 64-bit result to the 64-bit sign integers contained in RDHI and RDLO. Okay, so if we talk about this instruction, that is unsigned multiply and accumulate long. So in this instruction, basically what happened in the previous section, multiply and accumulate, we have studied there is separate registers inside this. We can say accumulate, multiply and accumulate instruction. For example, if we take this example, then here we multiply these two registers and we add R5 inside this and then we store result inside this section. Okay, but if we see these instructions, that is multiply and accumulate, sign or unsigned numbers, then here there is no extra registers to add. Okay, during multiply and accumulate instruction. So what this instruction normally do, this instruction obviously multiply this RM and RS first and then this instruction add this two register contents, that is RD high and RD low. And then after adding these two register contents, the result is again stored into the RD high and RD low. Okay, so result will be stored into this, but first multiplication of this will be performed and then addition of these two operands will be addition of this RDL 0 and RDH 0 is performed, and then result is again stored into the RDH and HI and RDL 0 register. Now this is this instruction is similar to the like in 8051 we studied one instruction, for example add A comma R 0. So in this instruction basically R0 content is added into the accumulator and result is again stored into the accumulator. So similarly here also these registers are added first and then again result is stored into these registers. Okay, so we'll see few examples related to these instructions. So first unsigned multiply long. So unsigned multiply long, so again this R5 and R6 registers will be multiplied, and as per the format, if you see, we have to store lower 32 bits inside this RDL0. So this is RDL0 register and upper 32 into this register, that is R4. So for that purpose we are writing this R4 first, because we store upper 32 bits inside this register and lower 32 bits we store into the R0 register, and then R5 is nothing but your RM, and then RS is nothing but your R6. So multiplication of these two numbers will be performed. Okay, now unsigned multiply and accumulate long. Okay, now here this instruction is little bit tricky. Okay, so here we have to consider this is RDL0 and this is RDHI. Okay, so obviously result will go into these two registers. Okay, now for that purpose first we are writing this R5, so sorry, here R5 will come because this is higher bit, higher 32 bit, and here R4 will come. Okay, so is equal to R3 and R8. So multiplication of these two registers will be done first, and then R5 is nothing but higher 32 bit number, and R4 is lower 32 bit number. Okay, so these two numbers, two register contents will be added, and then result of this particular addition will be stored into the again R5 and R4 register. Okay, so in this way the unsigned multiply and accumulate instruction normally work. Okay, so the unsigned multiply and accumulate instruction performs a multiplication on sign operand, that is RM and RS. So here they have mentioned in detail. So RM and RS, they perform the sign unsigned multiplication. The 64 bit result, so it will generate the 64 bit result of multiplication, is added to RL0 and RDHI. So again this result will be added into these two operands. The sum is returned to RDL0 and RDHI. Okay, now next is sign multiply and accumulate long. So here the execution of this particular instructions are same. So first this R3 and R8 are multiplied, then this lower 32 bit, that is R4, and upper 32 bit, that is R5, they are added into this result, and again result will be stored into this R5 and R4 register, that is RDHI and RDLO. Okay, so here the difference is these are sign numbers. Okay, and again sign multiply long, so again multiplication of these two numbers will be performed and result will be stored into the R4 and R0, because this is lower 32 bit, that is RDLO, and this is RDHI. Okay, so in this way these instructions are executed. I hope this explanation with this explanation you get understanding of these instructions. Okay, so these are the related to multiplication instructions which are available in ARM7. Okay, thank you.